What is up, guys? NPS River here, back at it with another video. Really excited for this one. We are getting a starfish for the NPS system today. It's one that I've been like keeping my eye on for a long time, and it's like one of the only inverts I don't have in my tank other than my feather stars. So super excited to get this guy in the tank. We're at my local fish store, Divine Aquatic Supply, on Old US 33 in Elkhart. So be sure to check them out. I'll probably give a short tour of the store before we head home. But yeah, we got a starfish for my NPS system. We got a starfish for my parents' mixed reef. And then we have a anemone for my sister's Clarkie anemone fish. So we're going to go ahead, get inside, and check it out. Alright guys, so I hope you enjoyed that small little montage of Divine Aquatic Supply in Elkhart, Indiana. Like I said, that is in Elkhart on Old US 33. Look it up and check it out. We have quite a bit of stuff in stock right now, but it will not be in stock very long because stuff sells out quick. So try to get there ASAP if you want something, or just let us know, we can try to special order you something. We've got two starfish out right now. The tile star is down in my parents' tank, like I said earlier, and then we got the blue Lincka in here, so I'm going to share some care facts for that and show you the other starfish downstairs if the light's not off. So today we got a blue Lincka starfish. This is one of the most gorgeous starfish in my opinion, but also one of the hardest to keep in the aquarium hobby. Many people that keep them don't even keep them for over a month before they just disintegrate and die. So the one thing people know for sure that they eat is sponges, and I got a bunch of sponges that actually kind of need to be eaten up. This is pretty much my rock throughout the whole NPS tank because it's just all just covered in sponges and different microorganisms. There's tunicates all over rocks and everything, a couple sea squirts. Hopefully it doesn't attack the big sea squirts up there, but there's plenty of sponges for him to eat. In fact, I kind of like it because some of this stuff is growing out of hand. So I almost pulled some of it out the other day, but I was like, hey, why not get something really gorgeous to help out with that? And I have heard witnesses of him eating TDO Chroma Boost from Reef Nutrition, so we're going to try that out. But I do have a good supply of sponges, so not too worried about him starving or anything right now. So hopefully we can get him on some TDO here soon. But they are very, very delicate. I acclimated the starfish for probably just about 2 hours. And I recommend that for any starfish, even chocolate chips. I mean, chocolate chips in that genus are a little bit more hardy, but I still recommend a good acclimation because all starfish are very picky and delicate. Like I said, they are very finicky with high nitrate levels. They will dissolve real quick, especially in high nitrate levels. pH needs to be at a steady like 8.4, 8.3, and your alkalinity needs to stay about the same as your normal coral, so you really don't have to worry about the alkalinity if you don't have much problems with that. But your salinity is another big thing, so I recommend having an auto top off so you don't really have to worry about salinity constantly. Like I said, this is a gorgeous animal to keep, but I recommend having a very well-established tank, like I said, with lots and lots of sponges for them to crunch on, as well as microorganisms. But like I said, we've got a bunch of sponges, so I'm really not too worried about him starving. Hopefully he starts eating here real soon. He's already been around the tank a few times, and it looks like he's heading over towards the sponges, so really excited. Just look at that coloration. Gorgeous. So right now we're gonna go ahead and run downstairs real quick. Like I said, I just want to give you a couple care requirements. on this guy, and I would consider him expert only. Not saying I'm an expert, but I am kind of saying that this tank is very, very established, so hopefully we can have a good, long life with him. There's a sand sifting star kind of hanging out over there, too. You don't see him very often. But we're going to head downstairs and show you the Formia tile starfish in the next reef.
So I ended up doing a voiceover on this because my brother and my dad are talking in the background, but this is the red tile Formia starfish. It is a little easier to care for than the blue Lincka that I have upstairs in my NPS system, but I do recommend still a very long acclimation for him. I think this guy was acclimated for about 2 hours. So all starfish should really be acclimated pretty well because they are all delicate animals, but this guy's already cruising around the rocks, seems to be doing very well.
Well guys, thank you for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Really excited to see how that starfish does. There's a lot of things in that tank that people say, oh, you can't keep that. Oh, it's not gonna stay alive. A lot of that stuff I've kept alive longer than a lot of people. I have no clue why. I mean, I keep track of my parameters and everything and get them tested constantly. But I mean, I feed a lot. I mean, a lot of this stuff is corals that people don't usually keep or don't even try to mess with. Like the chili corals, the dendroneptias, the steroneptias. Like I said, really excited to see how that starfish does. I mean, I hope he does extremely well and lasts me years. I've read reports, like I said, of them eating TDO Chroma Boost, and people know for sure that they do eat sponges. That's the one thing people struggle with when getting these starfish is they're not in, they put them in a non-established tank that doesn't have sponges and other diatoms for their starfish to eat. So really excited to see how that does in the NPS system. So I'll definitely have updates kind of every few weeks. Maybe we'll throw the starfish in one of the videos and share how he's doing. So real excited to see the progress there. Don't forget to be the fish. Feed them corals. We'll see you next time.